Well, hello and welcome aboard. This is Bug Eater 64, getting ready to do another flight here in my virtual airline Air America Duet. We subcontract with Solus Wings, which is a good friend's virtual airline, and by golly, we're getting ready to take off on another flight. This is going to be a fairly long flight. It's 1,043 miles, and we're going to be using that fine lady you see right there, the 737-900, a very modern version of a very old and dependable local commuter jet, regional jet, and we're going to be carrying some passengers, and it's going to be a job flight's flight. But before we get started, this is kind of a special flight. This flight was actually requested by someone who had seen one of my videos. Goes by the name of SimFlyer. So I want to let SimFlyer know that this flight is just for him. But also, it's for all my subscribers. I now have almost 200 subscribers to my YouTube channel, and by golly, I want to thank each and every one of you. I do this strictly for fun. I don't get any pennies to help things along. I'm an old, grizzled, retired. I've had two full careers, one military and one law enforcement, and now they say it's not the age, it's the mileage. Well, there's a lot of mileage on this carcass, and I'm full-time retired and just doing this for a great deal of fun because I love flying, always have, and I guess I always will. So I also want to say thank you to Nerd Show and Tell, who is an awesome Twitch streamer. Guy's amazing. He puts on just an incredible show. Right now, we've been working very hard in Star Citizen, but he's also a DCS flyer. That's where I met him a little more than a year ago, and he's amazing. And I just wanted to say thank you to him and let him know that you see this Squadron 42 hat? He made that possible. A number of weeks ago, I won a gift card from him during his show, and I used it to purchase this brand new Squadron 42 hat, and I like it. Like it a lot. So thank you, Nerd Show and Tell. And if you're anybody who sees this video, give him a look at in Twitch. He's there Monday through Friday, and just a lot of fun to take part in his show. So with that being said, today's flight, let's get back to that. Today's flight is gonna go from Grand Cayman, where we're sitting here, and we're going to St. Martin, 1,043 miles. So with that, let's get on our way and get things started. And once again, thank you so much for coming. Hope you enjoy the flight. I certainly enjoy bringing them to you, and we'll see you inside. All right, so here we are, Grand Cayman, and it's a beautiful morning. So let us get started here. Let's take a look. And okay, so we'll get things started. First things first. Get our ground services, set the chocks, connect the GPU.
And Owen Roberts, INTL information Zulu. 1100 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 46,000 scattered.
Don't need him right now. Okay, let's Let's go up here. About pushback right now. Start the loading and cleaning. Alright, and while they do that, we will take a look at our FMC. First things first. Flight plan. All right. Fuel's on board, so that's all looking good. Initial point. So it is MWCR. Destination is going to be TNCM. Okay, now cost we're gonna put about 50. Reserves 1.5. Cruising altitude is going to be 18,000. Go back here. Okay, we'll stop that. Fuel weight and balance. Okay, ZFW is going to be 116.3. Okay.
Owen Roberts, INTL Information Alpha.
Runway 0800
Zulu weather. Wind calm, visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 46,000 scattered, 48,000 scattered, temperature 14, dew point minus 15. Altimeter 2992. Arriving runway 08, departing runway 08.
Very good.
Advise on initial contact, you have Alpha.
I'll do her. And departure 08. And I think it's now row 2. And arrival. I think we're planning on, well, it's always, it's 10. It's runway 10. And okay, so see what we got here. Okay, so that's looking good. Flaps 15. Center of gravity is 17.5. Trim 537. That's all set. Go ahead and double check. Okay.
The captain has turned on the seatbelt sign. Please return to your seat and fasten your seatbelt.
And I'm not sure this is working yet. Okay, so let's see if we can get better pushback to work. And that may not be working either. Well, son of a gun. I've never used that before. That's interesting. Learn something new every day. Let's see if we can get an engine started here. And when that little number gets to about 24, we'll give her some fuel. Getting any readings here. Looks like she's settling down. Okay. Let's look at engine number two. And we will log into flight jobs and start the flight. So we'll start getting credit for it. Okay. Now with that, Everything's looking good there. Now, we got some issues up here. There we go. Alright, so we'll just have to sit here and wait for that. It didn't work the first time. That's not good. Alright, so let's look at this. Realism settings, align time. No strain on yaw. Differential braking.
We're ready up front. Everybody's closed up outside. We're just waiting to get some of our performance numbers and the clearance from air traffic control. We should be underway. It's our pleasure having you on board. Enjoy the flight. Should be underway here shortly.
As you're making
your
way,
please kindly
ask that you step into your row and out of the aisle as quickly as possible. Allow those passengers behind you to make their way to their seat as well. If you're traveling with a larger roller board, please place it in the overhead bins, either wheels or handles first, on either side of the aircraft. Keeping in mind that the overhead bin space is shared space, so if the bin directly above your seat is already full, please go ahead and utilize the next available space. If you brought in a second item with you, such as a briefcase, tote bag, laptop bag, backpack, please go ahead and utilize that space under the seat in front of you, so that we can utilize that overhead bin space for your larger bag without having to check in plain sight to your final destination. Feel free to utilize your mobile phone, tablets, and e-readers while we're here at the gate. However, once we close our boarding door, you must please place these items into airplane mode or turn off your cellular service. Please also note that if you will be working on a laptop computer or enjoying any other larger electronic devices, they must be stowed either in a bag under the seat in front of you or in the overhead bin. Please do not stow these items in the seat pocket in front of you, place them directly on the floor, or hold them on your lap during taxi takeoff and landing. Not just a Delta policy, but an FAA regulation for your safety. I'd like to thank you all for choosing to fly Delta. Welcome on board. Ladies and gentlemen, we have received our final paperwork, and we are ready for an immediate departure. Before we can move the aircraft, all passengers must be seated with your seatbelt securely fastened, your tray table sectarian items stowed, your seat back in the upright and long position, and your aisle armrests are lowered.
2 minutes left, and our alignment will be complete.
Welcome aboard, and thanks for flying with Delta. Our first priority on every flight is safety. So before we depart, I'll be giving a brief safety presentation. Okay, be sure all carry-on items are securely stowed in an overhead bin, and place smaller items under the seat in front of you. and ensure all aisles, exits, and bulkhead areas are clear. Delta now allows U.S. domestic passengers to use handheld devices like tablets and cell phones on board at any time, as long as all cellular functions are disabled. Larger electronic devices like laptops should be turned off and stowed until we're airborne.
And the princess wrote all the instructions.
Please note, some electronic devices may not be used in flight at any time. You'll find additional information regarding electronic devices in the in-flight information section of Sky Magazine. This plane features Wi-Fi.
Yeah, she's ready, man, cranky. All right.
If you're unable to perform these functions, please let us know, and we'd be happy to find you another seat. As we leave the gate, make sure your seatbelt is fastened. To fasten, insert the metal tip into the buckle and adjust the strap so it's low and tight across your lap. To release the belt, just lift the top of the buckle. Please remain seated with your seatbelt securely fastened anytime the seatbelt sign is on. And even if the sign is off, please keep your seatbelt fastened in case we experience any unexpected rough air. For everyone's safety, federal regulations require all passengers to comply with the posted placards and lighted information signs located throughout the cabin, in addition to any crew member instructions. Smoking is not allowed on any Delta flight. And federal law prohibits tampering with, disabling, or destroying a Russian smoke detector. There are 8 exits on this plane.
Okay, so now we are ready to go.
Have detachable slides that can be used for flotation. Life rafts are located in ceiling compartments at the front and center of the plane. All exits are clearly marked with an exit sign. However, if there's a loss of power and cabin visibility is reduced, lights will illuminate the aisle and lead you to an exit. Please take a moment to find the exit.
Let's get this thing moving. Simulation issue.
Be sure to adjust your own mask before helping
thing is stuck. Anyway, let's get on our way. Since we've got to go all the way down here to this runway. There are no real taxiways at this airport, so basically you have to go down here and then backtrack onto the
approaching 08.
So we just back taxi
on runway
all the way down
26. Flaps.
Yes. Itching Betty. Both the Air America Due and Solus Wings hangars and maintenance areas. Our 737 in the air here shortly and be on our way. Another beautiful day in Grand Cayman. Differential braking here to get us turned around and get lined up for takeoff.
Flaps.
Okay.
Ladies and flaps gentlemen, in we do thank take you very much position. For your attention, and now we invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the takeoff. The captain has made tower communications available, so if you'd like to monitor the air traffic system, you'll find that on channel 9 and your headsets in the seat pocket in front of you. We'll give you a little more information about our service plan for our flight as soon as we're in the air. Thank you, and again, welcome aboard.
Rotate.
1,000 feet remaining.
Possibly.
Gear up.
400.
Flaps up. Goodbye to the island.
gentlemen, we have now passed the altitude of 10,000 feet. All electronic devices may now be switched off from airplane mode. This aircraft is also equipped with Wi-Fi. Please see a flight attendant for more information.
Everything's looking good. So, we are on our way. So with that, we'll get back with you when we're getting ready to start our descent into St. Martin. So sit back, enjoy the flight, and we will see you very soon. Okay, we are now approaching the coast and get ready to overfly Haiti and the Dominican Republic. So we're moving right along. Got about, excuse me, about 650 miles to go. So hope you're enjoying the flight. Everything's been going just fine and been uneventful. Let's hope it stays that way. So we'll see you soon. Enjoy. So here we are, flying over the middle of the Dominican Republic. Now this is the latest update of X-Plane 11. This is X-Plane 11.30B for Beta 2. And you can see they've done some nice changes. Look at the blur from the heat from the engines coming off. That looks kind of cool. That's a nice thing, instead of having that black smoke. 737-900. And this is actually a freeware aircraft that is available on the org. And I'll tell you a little bit more about it. This is actually the pre-release. And this is an ongoing project, and it is absolutely a beautifully rendered aircraft. And we're cruising along at about 303 knots at our ground speed is 392, and we're at 18,000 feet. So, like I said earlier, it's a beautiful morning. On this thing here, go back to the beginning. This is completely interactive, very cool panel. Not everything works on it, but some of the things do. So again, well worth the price of admission. And I'll give you information about this aircraft. I would highly, because of the amount of work that's gone into this, you can donate to the group that is developing it, and I would highly recommend if you can donate to them, because they really have done a tremendous amount of work on this jet. So that being said, we will see you again very shortly. We got a few more hours to go before we get to our descent. Back and enjoy. Okay, so we've started our descent, starting to slow down, leaving 18,000 feet, heading for 1,700 feet. And that should put us about 3 miles away from the end of the runway. So shortly, in about 17 nautical miles, we'll be making our turn. As we come on to Dante waypoint. And that little island you see off there to the left of the windscreen, that's actually called the bottom. No idea how they came up with that name.
Princess Juliana INTL.
That's what I've been waiting for.
1500 Zulu weather. Wind calm.
2992, that's what we're at.
Sky conditions 46,000 scattered, 48,000 scattered, temperature 14, dew point minus 15. Altimeter 2992. Arriving runway 10, departing runway 10. Advise on initial contact you have mine.
Very good. Big question is Bug Eater going to be able to put this thing on the runway and stop it so that the passengers are happy and we don't break the airplane? After such a nice flight, I'd hate to mess it up now, but it wouldn't be the first time. Looks like our island right up there. So with that, let's go ahead.
The captain has turned on the seatbelt sign. Please return to your seat and fasten your seatbelt.
Turn some lights back on for landing. Start slowing down the airplane. thinking, if I remember correctly, that runway is right in here. It comes in right over the beach. If necessary, we'll do a go around. And we'll just keep losing altitude. Airplane is mine. Okay, so get lined up here.
Too high. Too high. Approaching 1-0.
Okay, so.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our destination. For your safety and comfort, please remain seated until the captain turns off the fasten seatbelt sign. Please check around you for any personal belongings.
On runway.
Please also use caution when opening the overhead lockers, as heavy articles may have shifted during the flight. On behalf of the flight crew, thank you for flying with us, and have a pleasant day.
All right, we made it.
Regarding ground transportation, baggage claims, or any other information, a Uniform Delta agent leading this flight will be more than happy to answer any questions you may have. On behalf of Delta Sky Team, our global partners, and especially your flight crew, we'd like to thank you all for flying with us. We've enjoyed having you on board, and look forward to the opportunity to serve you once again.
So we made it safely. And it was a pretty good landing once we found the airport, or the runway, I should say. Get over here to the terminal. Park our little lady. That's our gate right there. Welcome to St. Martin. Very good. All right.
the captain has turned off the seatbelt sign. You may now take off your seatbelt.
And we can finish the flight. And flight is finished. Most excellent. Thank you very much. Alright, most excellent. Well, okay, there you have it. We've made it. Passengers were happy. We got paid for the flight. Made a decent landing. About 156 feet per minute on the landing. So I've got no complaints with that. And we're at St. Martin's. So, sure hope you enjoyed the flight. Thanks again for coming. Thanks again to all my subscribers. And once again, thanks to Nerd Show and Tell for putting on such a great Twitch stream. And we're looking forward to the next year. He just celebrated his first year. And by golly, we sure have a lot of fun. I sure hope you had fun with this. If you did, if you liked it, click the thumbs up. If you didn't, click the thumbs down, by golly. And please leave any comments. I sure appreciate hearing from you fine folks. And if you got suggestions of places you'd like to see me fly and maybe a type of aircraft you'd like to see me fly, feel free to put that in the comments too. Like I said, this flight was requested by SimFlyer, and whenever possible we try to accommodate the request. So, welcome again to St. Martin, and this is Bugeater64 saying, until next time, y'all have a great time, and we'll see you in the skies. And as always, safe flying.